Hi guys, this is Nanu Simam and you are watching Gateway Solution. In this video, I am going to solve a very good lead code question based on array. And question goes like this: given an array ARR of integer, check if there exists two integer n and m, such that n is double of m. So if you see the example, you will get a better understanding. So here is a input array, and in input array we have element as 10, 2, 5 and 3, and we have to check each element, that is there any other element which is double of that particular element available. If it is found, then we have to return true. In this case, we have first element as 10, and we will check if there is any other element which is double of this particular element or half of this element. So in this case, here it is 10 and we have 5 here. If we double 5, if we multiply 5 by 2, we will get 10. So in this case, it should be true. If there will be no element of such kind, then our output will be false. I hope you got the question. Now we will try to understand in whiteboard and we will come out with the solution. So I will take the given example only, which is 10, 2, 5, and take some other element as 7. Okay, and I will give index 0, 1, 2, and 3. So length of array will be 4, and output of this array is going to be true. So here I will go with three approaches. Our first approach, time complexity, is going to be big O of n square, and this approach is going to be simple, and there is no pre-request for this. And in our second approach, our time complexity is going to be O of n log n, which is a bit better solution than our previous solution. And in our third approach, our time complexity is going to be big O of n, which is the best approach. And for these two, pre-request is that you have to know a little bit about collection, how we can use collection, and most precisely how we can use set. You have to know. If you don't know anything about collection and you never heard this word, then after watching our video till here, till the simple solution, you can exit, you can left out this video. So first we will go with the simple solution. In this solution, we are going to iterate this array two times. So our time complexity is going to be big O of n square. So first we will iterate by using I from 0 to till n minus 1. And again, we will iterate by using j from 0 to n minus 1. And what we will do inside this, we will check a condition. If first we will check i not equal to j, and this condition is obvious because if we are checking at ith position and for checking at same position as j, it is completely nonsense, out of sense. So what we will do here, first the condition will be our I not equal to j, and what we will check, arr of I into 2, is it equal to arr of j? If we found any element of such kind, then what we are going to do, return true. And if we will not find any element of such kind, we will do what? Return false. So this is our simple solution. We will try to implement this solution first. And first we will go with see how much is the time complexity, since we are iterating from 0 to n here, and again iterating from 0 to n. So our time complexity is going to be n into n, which is big O of n square in this particular solution. We will improve our solution later. First we will try out this solution. So I will type the code here. We are going to use two loop, and for int I equal to 0 and I less than arr dot length and I plus plus. Similarly, another for loop for j, variable j, for int j equal to 0, j less than arr dot length and j plus plus. Now we will check our condition. If I not equal to j and arr of I into 2 is equal to arr of j, then what we are going to do, return true, simple, return true, which means that we found the element which is double of the element. It's quite simple. And if we will not found such kind of element and we come out of the loop, then what we are going to do, return false. Simple. Now I will try to run this code. Hopefully it will run. There will be no issue. Wow. Run again. Yeah, expected is true and my answer is also true. Now I will try to submit. Hopefully it will get accepted. Yeah, it got accepted. Now we will go with the next solution. Next solution, we will try the same approach, but we will use collection here to improve our result. So what we are going to do here, we are going to use tree set to find n log n. And we are going to use set a collection. We have a collection which is named as tree set, and using tree set, we will introduce a set variable and we will type it new tree set. Means we are going to create an object of set, and in that set we have a function named as set.contents, and set.contents has a time complexity of log n, and we don't have to use one more for loop, that nested for loop. So our whole time complexity is going to be, for first for loop it is going to be n, and for using contents if we will search, and for that we have a time complexity of log n. So our whole time complexity will be n log n. So now we will implement same thing in solution, and solution goes like this. We will remove this for loop since we are not going to use it. So I will declare our tree set here, tree set, let's call it as set, and new tree set. And what we will do, we will check a condition. If set dot contents arr of I into 2, then we will return true. And after, if it didn't contain, then what we are going to do, we simply add it to set.add arr of I, and hopefully it will work. True. Now I will try to submit it. Now we are getting some wrong answer. Why? Okay, now we have to check this also. If arr of I modulo 2, we have to check if it is divisible by 2, then also which there is a element which is available, which means that we have to return true. And this whole thing we have to do inside a bracket, because we are going to consider it as a one element, and then if and then set dot contents arr of I by 2. If it contains half of the element or if it contains double of the element, in both the case we have to return true. So let's run it once again. Hopefully this time our solution will get accepted, true, and submit. Yeah, our solution got accepted. And if you know that how tree set internally store the data, and tree set store the data in a binary tree format, first it will sort the data. So suppose if it found data 10, and after that it will check if we add another data, after that it will check that if the new data is greater than 10 or less than 10. If it is less than 10, it will store here, and if it is greater than 10, it is going to store here. But it is not greater than 10, then again it will store 5 here, and since 5 is greater than 7, so again 7 will store here. So this note is nothing is there. So the complete tree set for in the above example will be like this: 10, 2, 5, and 7. So for doing this operation, we are going to spend unnecessary time. And in this question, nowhere they asked that we need a sorted array or something like this. So our time complexity is n log n. Now we will try to reduce it more, even more, so that our time complexity will become big O of n. And how we will do it? Just by using some magical word, and the word is hashSet. HashSet will do hashing. HashSet will not follow a tree set pattern. And that's the HashSet, and our time complexity will improve. I will tell you in detail how our time complexity will improve. First, we will see that we are getting output or not. I will try to submit it. Yeah, it got accepted. Now I will see the details. How is our time complexity? Yes, you are here. Your runtime beats 98.76 of Java Summation. Means we are ahead of 98.76 people. So now I will tell you that how our time complexity got improved in HashSet. In tree set, if we use contents, our complexity is going to be log n. And in HashSet, if we use contents, our complexity is going to be big O of 1. And big O of 1 into big O of n, it is going to be we go of n only. And why it is improved? Because in hash set, a hash mapping is done for each element. Suppose we have 10 here, and for 10 there is going to be some hash map which is going to be unique here, and it will store 10. And for 2 also, one hash will create it, and 2 will store here. And when we are going to check that if this hash set contain this particular element, it will directly go to the element and pick from there. So time complexity is going to be big O of 1. So in this way, our time complexity will reduce, and it will reduce to big O of n, and we are going to get a best solution. Hopefully you understood. Thank you for watching. Consider sharing and subscribing.